So now we are going to use round and m round function to round these numbers to nearest 10, nearest 100, nearest 50. Similarly, you can do this exactly same procedure for nearest thousands and all that. Suppose first let us start with using the round function. Now suppose if I use the round function and I select this number and I want to round it to nearest 10. So number of digits, if I mention 10 maybe, then the answer which I'll get is not correct. I'll get this exact same answer again because this 10 signifies or means the number of digits after the decimal place. So this stands over here for the number of digits after the decimal place. So it doesn't matter that you want to round it to the nearest 10, because it will give you the exact same answer as I have just two decimal places over here. Now, or what you can do, you can simply write a 1 and check. So that also won't work, because this is how you won't get the nearest 10 answer. So how do we deal with this using the round function is that we simply write a minus 1. So the moment we write a minus 1 over here, it will understand that it has to go before the decimal place, not after the decimal place. And it has to go for a single or a 10. Basically, it has to round this number to nearest 10. It just have to go one place to the left. This minus 1 signifies, writing minus over here signifies that we have to go before or on the left of the decimal place, and specifying 1 over here, minus 1 over here, gives the Excel that okay, you just need to move one step towards the left. So it is basically rounding your number to nearest 10. So this gives you answer of 78,900. Now over here, nearest 10 would lead to an answer of 680. So let us check whether this works. Yes, 680. We have just selected the number and we have written a minus 1. Basically, what is nearest 10, what is nearest 100? This means it basically rounds your number so that you don't have to deal with any 2s, 1s, 3s. It simply gives you a 0 in the 10th place. In this unit's place, it gives you a 0. Similarly, this will be rounded to 350. Let us check. So yes, we have a 350 over here. So this is how it rounds the number by just writing round minus 1. Similarly, we can do it for 100. If we want to get the nearest 100, I can just simply write minus 2. So minus 2 will, first of all, writing minus over here means that you need to go towards the left of the decimal. And writing a 2 means you need to go twice. You need to jump twice. And jumping twice means that you need to round your number to nearest 100. So now let us check. Your answer is 900. Here your answer should be 700. So let us check. Yes, 700. Here it should be 300, and you have 300. So this is exactly how you do the rounding for decimal places. Instead, this is not in the decimal places we are dealing with. We are dealing with the numbers itself. So I need to get the nearest 10 or the nearest 100, and this is the procedure you can do this with using the round function. Now the same thing if you want to find the nearest 50, basically if you want to find the nearest 50, then how do you deal with that? Let us just check round. I'll take this number, and then if you write minus 5, then that becomes wrong, because that minus 5 is basically stating that minus 5 is stating that you need to go towards the left 5 times, which means you are basically calculating your answer to nearest 1 lakh. So that is not what we want. We want it to nearest 50. So this we cannot use, we cannot do using the round function. So instead of the round function, we now, for finding nearest 50 or nearest 500 or nearest 5, what we do is we take the m round function, which is a new function you are going to learn. M round function. So I'll select the number, and the multiple over here is straight away to what multiple you need to round your answer to. So if it's a 10, I'll just simply write a 10 over here. I do not have to mention any minus 1, minus 2. So that's not an issue over here. You just give the multiple that you wanted to nearest 10, you wanted to nearest 20, you wanted to nearest 30. You can just give the multiple, any multiple you want to, and you get the answer accordingly. Similarly, I'll do it for this nearest 100. So instead of just writing minus 2, you'll just write a multiple of 100. You'll get a number rounded to nearest 100. Exactly same way we do this, which is m round and rounding it to nearest 50. So the multiple is 50, so I'm just writing 50 over here and you get the answer. So this is how we do the rounding. Let us go and check for this as well. Let us drag this down. So I'll explain the difference between nearest 100 and nearest 50 for those who don't know this. It's 3, 4, 5. So when you are rounding it to nearest 100, you want these two places to be 0, the units and the tens place to be 0. So what do you do? Either this will go to 300, because this 3, 4, 5 lies between 300 and 400, and the midpoint is 350. So anything which is to the left of 350 will be rounded to 300, and anything which is to the right of 350 or it is a 350 will be rounded to a 400. Here it is left, here 345 is left of 350, so it's rounded to 300. Similarly, if you can see for here, in this case, this is between 600 and 700. So it can be rounded either to 600 or to 700. But as this is to the right of 650, hence it is rounded to a 700. So this is how you work. And for nearest 50, how do we deal with that? Is that at the end, you require a 50. Basically, you are going to go between 6, this can be 600 or 650, right? It can be 600 or 650. I'm so sorry, this will be between 650 and, so I'll just write it down, 650 and 700. So this number for nearest 50, I'm explaining, can range between 6, 5, 6, 5, 0. So either this or it can be 6, 5, 700. For those who don't know how to do the basic rounding, so now it's going to lie between these two, right? Just because I'm rounding it to nearest 50, so it should be between 650 to 700. And the middle portion, the middle of this number is 675. So as this is towards the right of the 675, so you're rounding it to 65, 700. Similarly, for this number, this will be lying between 300 and 350. 300 and 350, because we are dealing it in 50s. So your range should also be of 50. So 300 and 350, either it can go to 300 or it can go to 350. But just because this is towards the right of 325, the answer we get is 350. So if I make this, suppose if I make this as 303. So now if this is 303, it should lie between again 300 and 350. But as this is towards the left of 325, the nearest 50 answer which I get is 300. See, the answer is now 300. This is how you work out with the nearest tens, hundreds and fifties for those who don't know how to take out the numbers to nearest 10, 100 and 50. So if you want nearest 50, you always use a m round function. You can't have round function for that. So the multiple over here will simply be the 50. So you can use the best way to use to get the nearest 10, nearest 100 is to use the m round function. Why? Because in that you can just specify the, even if you get confused whether you need to write minus 1, minus 2 or minus 3 using the round function, you can just simply give the multiple to which you need to approximate your answer. So I have summarized this in my PPT. You can just have a look.